So we're here today with Matthew McClure, who is running for Waterford Township Trustee. How are you today?
Oh, I'm fine. Just locked up like everybody else. And that's going to be ending soon. So just trying to do my part and make sure everybody else is safe while I'm safe too.
Great. Well, thank you for doing this interview. Can you tell us why you decided to run for trustee?
Well, originally in 2016, I was asked, and I was a late ballot person that got in because the party had a space in that position. But as I ran for the position and we had a large slate, five candidates, I started knocking a lot of doors, and you start to realize all the things that people have concerns about in the community. And we had one of the largest, most prolific campaigns and knocked nearly 25,000 doors. I didn't really have a real fair shake at that year because I was I run the Dare to Inspire Riverwalk Festival in Waterford, and I was knee deep in that. But I did pretty well. It wasn't really that cycle of a year where you would expect a candidate from my party to win, but I came pretty close. But as you knock the doors, you start to realize what your concerns are, aren't what everybody else's concerns are, and you start to put tools in your tool belt, and not only do you start to understand what it is that the community is, you understand what the community's lost, you understand what the community needs, and as a person that lived a very fulfilled life in Waterford, and with parents who were very involved also, I got a scholarship, from Waterford Mott. You start to feel like it's your debt to pay. And once you've acquired that kind of information, it's like having tools in your tool belt. And some of the answers to the questions sometimes answer more than one problem at the same time. And so you start to think maybe I have something to offer the community.
So what are some of those issues that you want to work on if you're elected?
Well, centralized commerce, a central identity. We lost the mall a great many years ago. And even in the good times, we've made some progress on the issue. It's finally torn down there. But, we haven't been able to cash in our chips. And so even in the strong times, we really haven't made the win. We do see some light at the end of this tunnel. But what I see, though, is opposed to what is happening at the mall, which is more utilitarian, good jobs, doing a lot of tech stuff there. And it'll, be kind of like Applebee's and Ruby Tuesdays and things that you commonly see throughout other municipalities and other cities and townships that you can see, but I have a vision of a different type of commerce in Waterford, which is more centralized over by Oakland Yard in some space that's been there for quite a long time. I think it was intended for that originally before the mall. We happen to be dead center Oakland County. In fact, the marker for Oakland County is right there at M59 and Crescent, which is right by my festival that we do. In fact, we were going to rename that festival for the 200th anniversary, the Heart of Oakland Festival, and try to celebrate, but we all know what happened this year, so I may try to do something digital with that. But in retrospect, it really what I want to say is that is the center of everything in the heart of Oakland, and I think it's a great area for a commerce center, and it's pretty much flat. Most of it's Waterford owned. I see a more walkable destination style commerce with more unique and privately owned commerce, and the type of commerce that brings people from out of town into town. When you speak about a 7-Eleven or a McDonald's or a Gold Store or like a lot of the strip mall type things are more utilitarian. And what my vision is something that is more destination, where it's a walking experience, like you'd have in some of the nicer towns that have been around for a while that have a little more history. But we want to build it from scratch. So for years, I've been working on a seven-phase concept that I have no illusions is not super ambitious, but I've also broken it down into small pieces, a lot of things starting that could be grant-funded. I also see, in general, a more walkable Waterford, and when we started our Riverwalk Festival, rejuvenated the Riverwalk program, and now they're finishing that, and I see other extensions for that. I see a joint leadership board between the school district and the township. There isn't, it's a bit siloed right now, and there's not a lot of connectivity and common goals between the two boards right now, and some of the people on the boards will admit to you that they aren't working in the same directions. So more walkable Waterford. I definitely see more transparency. I see there's a real opportunity in local government, especially one of our size, which is about 72,000 people, where there's enough people to have a lot of great ideas, and there's a lot of resources within the community that don't cost money, that are grant funded, that can improve our quality of life, that can be tapped into and make for a more citizens-led agenda. Instead of, I'm not pointing this at anybody specific, but a lot of communities have sort of a kind of a tax and spend backroom type mentality where they come up with all the ideas themselves, and they're not creating agendas based on what the people have. So I kind of want to tear the doors off of town hall and take the show on the road.
So what are some of the ways you've been involved in the Waterford community?
Well, I like I was saying before we started, I donate probably, I log for the last 7 years, probably 1,000 to 1,200 hours in the community, whether it be with nonprofit work. Through our festival, we piloted a grant program for Michigan that was a 6,500 square foot mural underneath M59 or Highland Road in that area. And we didn't realize we were the pilot for a Michigan program at the time, but indeed we were the first, and we raised money under a bid process through Michigan Department of Transportation, and also on contract with Waterford for 3 years. And our bid was $0. And so we got the bid. But we also had very talented artists from New York and Florida and the UP and across Michigan. One of our artists, Quindell Mitchell, was on the cover of Metro Times twice for his urban art. And so we've been doing that as an annual program each year, donating 6,500 square foot mural, which is about a $50,000 mural. And we complete it during a festival that helps raise money for that. Also raises awareness of a very hidden Riverwalk raid on our 59 by Buffalo Wild Wings, and runs all the way to the skate park on Crescent Lake Road, called the Dare to Inspire Riverwalk Festival. And it'll be our seventh year running. I don't think we can do it this year. We may try to do some type of digital representation of it just so it's still annual. But we haven't decided that yet. We might just trim it down. I was really kind of hoping to have it to celebrate Oakland County's 200th anniversary, because we are absolutely dead center. We're the most centralized event in Oakland County. And I wanted to rebrand the festival as the Heart of Oakland Festival, which is what I want to rebrand Waterford as too, which is another thing, is rebranding Waterford and the Heart of Oakland and the center of everything. And to bring new, unique destination commerce and tie another portion of the Riverwalk into a new Main Street area. As well, I work with opioid groups to try anti-addiction opioid or opioid treatment. I've had town hall meetings with Dr. Kumar. I also have participated with our nonprofit for at-risk kids, for body dysmorphia, art therapy. We give art supplies to students and raise money for that. So it's kind of never-ending, you know. I've learned to live a little poor, working a little less, making a little less money, but I live a lot richer in the long run.
So what is some of the professional and job experience that you bring to the table?
When I was younger, I was retail management for many years, and I did a lot of design work. I went to an art college, Cleveland Institute of Art, and under scholarship, and also was at Case Western Reserve. And most of the students there get pulled out of college and recruited, and I did a lot of very high-end jewelry design at something similar to like a Tiffany's or Cartier, but it was Mary's Jewelers out of Florida and Georgia area. And that was kind of the pinnacle of that environment. And I dealt with things like Harry Winston and a lot of rare brands, some of the finest watches in the world, 25 watches above. I've designed watches before. So it was more lucrative than you might think in the design sense and the sales sense. But I've also done insurance claim construction. So we go in and make sure that the customers are getting what is supposed to be provided for them by the insurance company. I've also done branding and marketing, Nimble Jack branding, Pied Cypher events. Worked with 18 local businesses, not only just to make flyers, but literally redesign their weeks if they're an entertainment facility. I work with Modena Trucking, and I've worked with strategies with businesses to rebrand who they're trying to reach and why.
So if people want to know more about you and your campaign, where can they go?
Well, they can see our festival at www.dti-, which is the middle line, hyphen event, dti-event.com. And you can see some of the philanthropy, although I'm not trying to mix too much of that with politics. You could see my website, which is being transferred over right now. It's porting over. It'll be up in a couple days at McClure, all lowercase, McClure, numeral 4, Waterford, everything lowercase and no spaces, .com. Also at my Facebook page at Matthew K. McClure, 4, numeral 4, Waterford, Trustee Forum page. So I'm always available at any hour. If I'm up and you have a question, I'm going to take it.
Great. Well, thank you so much for doing the interview today.
Thanks. I appreciate your time.